have the picture, obviously, of the spine, but something's going on here, and I believe it's called kyphosis.
Yeah, so with kyphosis in general, kyphosis is when your spine angles change and you're actually hunched over and looking down. So that's kyphosis, and then lordosis would be the opposite, where you're looking up. And the main cause of kyphosis happens in this region here. So we talked about the cervical spine, the thoracic spine, and the lumbar spine. This area here is called the thoracolumbar junction, which is from the 11th thoracic spine to about the second lumbar vertebral body. And if you have a compression that causes wedging, where the top, the anterior portion of this vertebral body is lower than the posterior portion, you lose height in that anterior portion, and it's called a wedge angle. The greater the wedge angle, the greater your chance of kyphosis, and the greater the degree of that kyphosis is.
Is it very common, doctor? Kyphosis, when it comes to compression fractures?
Yes, the kyphosis is common, and it's really common in that region. So if it happens in the thoracolumbar junction in the degree of height, and that's when we get into treatment later, there are some types of vertebral augmentation where we can actually restore some of that height and decrease that wedge angle. And if done in the acute setting, it can help with the kyphosis.
Restore height. I love hearing that. And improve quality of life, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Right. So what's important when you have patients that have significant kyphosis is that these patients have respiratory compromise, they can't take deep breaths. They're at a fall risk because they're always bent over in this hunched over position.
Which can lead to more severe stuff.
Right, can lead to more severe things, and it can lead to more compression fractures.